You might know the problem. You buy some fancy shaped single cavity molds because they are looking really cute, but then you don't know how much soap batter fits in your mold and how much oil you need for your recipe. Of course, you don't want to make too much soap batter or even too less. In today's video, I show you how you can easily calculate how much oil you need so your soap fits perfect into your individual mold. I am Sue and my channel is all about soap making. For the calculation, it doesn't matter what the shape of your mold is or if you use the imperial or the metric system. This method works for every mold and units. I am using this cute wavy mold for 4 soap bars as example, and because I'm not familiar with the imperial system, I make my calculation in the metric system. But don't worry, I show you how you can also use the imperial system. The first we are going to do is to rate how much water fits in the mold. I'm putting the mold on a tray that makes it easier later to carry the mold and get rid of the water. Before you pour the water into the mold, remember that you have to tear your scale. Fill up your mold until the level you want your soap batter to be. Don't go up to the top and leave a little bit space. You also do not need to fill all molds, you only need one, and later you can multiply it by the number of molds you have. I have 4 molds here, so I would multiply it by 4. Now you can go the simple way and say that the weight of the water equals the amount of the total soap batter you need. That would be absolutely okay. When you want it a bit more accurate, then you have to consider that your soap consists mainly of oil, and oil is lighter than water. The density of oil is about 90% of the density of water. So you have to take your water weight and multiply it by 0.9. This is your total amount of soap batter you need to fill this mold. But you still don't know how much oil you need to use. For calculating this, grab your recipe and a soap calculator. I highly recommend to generally put every recipe you want to use in a soap calculator. When you take recipes from books or the internet, you never know if the person who wrote the recipe accidentally mixed up the numbers or if the calculation is completely wrong. So just to be sure you use the right amounts, double check it with the soap calculator. I'm using Soapcalc for this. If you don't know how Soapcalc works, then I recommend to check out the video I made about how to use Soapcalc. I linked it for you in the upper right corner. What we now want to know is how much oil we need for this recipe in percentage, meaning how big is the oil part of the soap batter. So let's first type the recipe into Soapcalc. After you typed in and calculated the recipe, you need just 2 numbers here from the print recipe page. The weight of the oils and the soap weight. Now you have to divide the oil weight by the total soap weight and multiply it by 100. This gets you the percentage of oil in your recipe. This number is mostly around 70%. Depending on how much water and lightest count you use, it can be a little bit more or less. Now that you know this number, you can easily go back to the water weight of your soap mold and multiply it with the percentage number you just calculated. And this is the amount of oil you want to use for this soap mold. Now let's go back and double check the numbers. Take the amount of oil you calculated and put it into the recipe calculator. Then calculate the recipe again and go to the print recipe page. The total soap weight should now fit the water weight you measured for your mold. When you want to fill multiple molds, you need to multiply it with the number of molds you want to use. This one has 4 molds, so I would multiply it by 4. You can use this method for any mold you like, it doesn't matter what shape it has, and as you can see, Soapcalc gives you the option to use pounds, ounces and grams, so you are also free to choose the unit you feel most comfortable with. Before we finish, there's one last point you should keep in mind when you use this method. This is for pure soap batter, without any additives. If you want to add colorants, clay, coffee grounds, poppy seeds or any other additives, the volume of your soap batter will be bigger. It is not very much and in most cases it won't be relevant, but I want you to consider that. This is why I told you at the beginning to not fill your mold up to the top with water. You will need some safety space if you want to use additives. I hope I could help you out with this problem. I would appreciate if you leave a comment telling me if this video was helpful for you, and it would be great if you leave a thumbs up. Thank you for watching, sharing, and subscribing. Have a great day and see you next time. Bye!